How to use Zoom. To begin using Zoom, go to zoom.us to create a Zoom account by clicking Sign Up. Once you've created an account and have logged in, click Host a Meeting. If you do not already have the Zoom app downloaded, a pop-up will appear that will ask you to download the Zoom app and run it. You will be required to have the Zoom app in order to use Zoom. Once you have the app downloaded, you can begin to use its many features. In the app's main screen, you can begin a new meeting, join a meeting hosted by another person, schedule a meeting for a later date, and share screen. We're going to click New Meeting so we can look at all of the in-meeting features. Once you start your meeting, you will be asked to connect your audio. At the bottom of the screen, you can find your controls. First, we have Mute, which mutes yourself from other participants in the meeting. You can unmute yourself simply by clicking the button again. The arrow beside Mute allows you to change your audio options. You can switch to other microphones or speakers you may have connected to your computer. Next, we have Stop Video. Stop Video disables your video so other participants can no longer see you. It does not stop the meeting or mute you. Then we have Security. This controls how participants can use the meeting and who can enter. By clicking Lock Meeting, you allow no other participants to enter the meeting. You can also determine if participants are allowed to use the share screen, chat, and rename themselves features. Next, we have participants, which is where the host can manage the participants in the meeting. At the bottom here, you can select Invite. This is where you can invite participants into your meeting. You have the option of choosing from your contact list or emailing an invitation out. Emailing the invite out creates a standardized email with all the information in it. Other options are to copy the invite link or copy the full invitation and then paste it into your own message. When copying the invite link, don't forget to include the meeting password, which can be found in the bottom corner of the pop-up. If we go back to the participants panel, you will see all the participants in the meeting listed. Here, you can control their video and also mute or unmute each participant individually. By clicking More, you can also rename or add a unique profile picture to each individual participant. At the bottom here, you can click Mute All, which is helpful for presentations or webinars, and unmute all. By clicking More, you can select to mute participants on entry, which is helpful to limit interruptions. Next, we have chat, which is where participants can send messages and files to one another. If you click the three dots on the right-hand side here, you can select who participants can chat with. Next, we have screen share. If you would like to share your screen with the participants so they can see a video or web page open on your computer, click screen share. In this pop-up, you can then choose which window or application you would like to share. You can also select files, which will share individual files and send them to each participant. Next, we have record. If you would like to screen record your meeting to share with others, post on an external page, or keep as a reference. When you're done, click end. As the host, it will give you the option to leave the meeting and allow others to remain in the meeting, or end the meeting for all, which will automatically close the meeting room. And that is how you use Zoom. If this helps you, let us know by liking this video or commenting below. And don't forget to subscribe for more how-to instructional videos.